In a message to men and women religious, Pope Francis said, "I want to say one word to you, and this word is joy. Wherever consecrated people are, there is always joy." And from my experience at Catholic Extension, I couldn't agree more. Beyond the joy that they bring, they are doing the heavy lifting by building the future of our church. I would like to share with you the story of three such women religious who show that through our faith, we are always more than our circumstances.
I'm Sister Fatima Santiago.
I am Emily Jackson.
I'm Sister Carolyn Kossip.
We have real mission territory here. We have people living way below the poverty line. This may be on the map as America, the United States, a first world country, but the Rio Grande Valley is definitely not that.
Colonias in my diocese would be families that are settling quickly and building their own homes and living them very poor conditions from all over Latin America. Many of them are undocumented, and yet trying to find a way to establish a life.
There is an emphasis on preferential love for the poor. And so there is a place where there's a need and nobody wants to go, that's where you find the ICM sister.
Because of the programs we have here, our people know one another, they interact with one another, and this center has become a second home for many of them.
You come into the Proyecto building and you see all these things happening. I mean, there's an area where the children are learning, there's a Head Start program, there's an area for medical needs. It's something that is so unique, but yet it's something that I would never expect anything else from these beautiful sisters.
I could see that the people are very strong in their faith.
So we said, well, it's obvious. We have a faith community. It just needs a home.
So that is where the need came to have a church.
So now this is their place that means so much to them because they're all raised as Catholics in Mexico, and they were really lost sheep until we had a Catholic church here for them, the center of their faith life.
Para mí, estar esta iglesia, este centro comunitario, estar estas hermanas aquí con nosotros en esta comunidad, es tener la presencia de Dios con nosotros.
Now we have people in the Proyecto that are talking about having their kids go to college and having their kids expand their horizons and, you know, that there is hope.
Amazing, isn't it? Women religious continue to do the vital work of empowering people, building community, and reaching the marginalized. The sisters, funded by Catholic Extension, are committed to training the lay leaders who will carry on the essential ministries of the church. In the last 5 years alone, Catholic Extension has provided nearly $7 million to support the work of women religious in 48 U.S. dioceses.